We are now past the 2-year mark since I started making video updates for this bizarre star, and while much has come to light since then, KIC 8462852 remains almost a complete mystery still. And, as this star has done since the beginning, just when you think we're getting close to an answer, it's thrown us yet another curveball. For more information on the backstory of this star, check out my other videos on the subject on this channel or in the dedicated playlist for it. At this point, alien megastructures as they were originally envisioned in relation to the star are essentially eliminated as a possibility, but not necessarily the activities of an alien civilization. More on that in a minute. Over the course of the year, the star has been photographed at different wavelengths of light, indicating that the material blocking the star's light is extremely small particles, likened to smoke particles, though oddly the size of the particles varies somewhat depending on where they are in the cloud. This eliminates solid alien megastructures as a possibility, since, as solid objects, they would block all wavelengths equally. So, for a time, the culprit appeared to be a dust cloud, albeit a weird one. There are two mysteries here. There also appears to be another dust cloud made up of much larger particles that's causing the long-term overall dimming trend of the star. As for the small material, it must be being actively made, or else it would be blown out of the star system rapidly. What process is creating this dust is not yet understood, though it could be disintegrating comets or asteroids in some type of cascade. Except that such things should be absorbing light from the star and re-radiating it in the infrared. No strong infrared emissions have been detected at this star. Why that is remains unclear. But now, things have gotten even stranger. In a paper by Gary Sacco and colleagues, they report a periodicity of 1,574 days that seems to be present in the star's dips. This is important because it would eliminate interstellar dust as a possible cause, and that the dust is indeed in orbit of KIC 8462852. This would mean that the dust orbits the star at about 3 astronomical units. That's fairly close. So where's all the infrared? In fact, it's so close that it's within the zone of habitability for this star. It was observed a while ago that some of the separations between the dips ended up being multiples of 24.2 days. More, Sacco notes that 1,574 comes out to 65 24.2 day periods. That's a weird one for sure. While it doesn't necessarily suggest that whatever this is related to an alien civilization, it does raise an eyebrow. And 2 years on, alien activity, while highly unlikely, is still on the table. Just what they'd be doing to create all that dust, however, would be an unknown. So there you have it. After over 2 years of study, KIC 8462852 still remains baffling. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.